We will now focus on protection as part of our attack principles. The principle is how we are going to accomplish our goal. Our goal may change based on the moment of the game or area of the field, but our principles of attack remain constant. We use five attacking principles. Each principle has sub-principles or smaller details that we use within each principle. Our five attacking principles are penetration, patience, positioning, protection, and pace. As a review, we'll look at penetration. There are three ways we can penetrate: with the dribble, the pass, or the shot. We simply ask ourselves, can we go forward? We need to have a forward-thinking mentality, our eyes up, our body open to advance, and understand that there are multiple solutions to go forward. Patience. This is if maybe we can't go forward. We should look to circulate the ball by playing negative or neutrally. We want to relieve pressure and understand that there are multiple solutions to go forward. Positioning. This is in regard to how we place ourselves within our team structure and our ability to use space. We want to orientate our body to be able to receive to penetrate, and we want to use diagonal support and play with teammates or options in quality spaces and areas. Protection, our fourth principle. Ball possession is very important, but we need to understand that we may lose the ball. Protection is negative support to help us retain and move the ball, but also help us regain the ball and stop the opponent in transition. Some of the concepts within protection: organization and stability. We'll use the principle of protection as a way to stay organized and provide stability to the team. We'll need to be aware of our reference points, which are the ball, the opponent, teammates, and the space, and also of our positional relationships within our team as we attack. Negative support. This is a term used to describe players underneath the ball. These players are instrumental in retaining possession, allowing us to switch play, but also being able to combine with the ball carrier with a passing combination or even an overlapping run. Relieve pressure. The opponent may be doing a very good job of defending in an organized manner. Using the principle of protection, we will be able to have options to relieve pressure caused by the opponent's defending. Switch the attack. Within this principle, we'll use negative support to switch the ball from a congested area into areas with more space, time, and opportunities. Counter press. When we are organized and have protection offensively, we will be able to transition quickly into a counter-pressing moment. The counter-press is when we will apply immediate pressure to the ball carrier and nearby players with an attempt to regain possession before the opponent can escape or get organized. If we can attack in an organized manner, we can counter-press in an organized manner. Regain the ball and interceptions. While the protection principle has attacking functions, we really want to be able to regain the ball, intercept passes, and sustain possessions. We will not always have perfect possessions, so it's important that we are anticipating a loss of possession and providing protection to regain the ball. Here's a small snippet from a Man City and Chelsea match. Man City, in light blue, is highly organized and stable within their team setup and spacing. They constantly provide penetrative forward options, but also have negative support and protection to relieve pressure when Chelsea tries to set a trap or win back the ball. Man City works to switch the attack a number of times to get Chelsea moving side to side. In this example, as Chelsea starts to set a trap, Man City evades it and gets a chance inside. Twice Chelsea will win the ball, once there, but they're unable to escape because of Man City's protection. The organized defensive mechanism, while in the attack, allows Man City to regain the ball, sustain possession, and apply more pressure on Chelsea. As we review penetration, meaning we want to go forward. Our second principle of patience, if we can't go forward, we want to move the ball backwards or sideways and restart the question of can we go forward. Positioning. This aspect and principle will help us with our spacing and structure of the team. And then protection. We want negative support or protection to be able to relieve pressure and retain possession, provide stability and organization to the team, switch the point of attack, and ultimately regain the ball, intercept passes, counter press, and sustain possessions so that we can score more goals while disallowing the opponent opportunities to score goals. If you have any questions about our attack principles, contact your coach or one of our directors.